It's great if he's making frequent deposits at the bank, right? We like that. Unless, of course, he's doing it at a sperm bank. A recent post on Pop Sugar's Circle of Moms asked women this interesting question. If your husband or partner wanted to donate sperm, would you be okay with this? Why or why not? What? No? All right, fam. Okay, okay. While one user said she'd be okay with it if it went to someone they knew, other users didn't want any unknown kids of their man running around these streets. So, ladies, would you be okay with your man making this type of charitable donation?
Yo, they're mad stingy with their sperm.
Dang!
So stingy.
Don't nobody want no community daddies.
There are people out there that need it.
I know, but... Yeah, no, I couldn't do that.
Yeah,
I'm very, no, I'm very possessive over my man's sperm. Like, I would seriously, no.
Really?
Yes, no, and I'm such a mother that I would find my way to that sperm and become a mother to that,
oh,
to that
hell
child.
No.
Yeah, no, that's just who I am. I wouldn't want that.
Can
I
you imagine?
I want little half atoms around there if I'm not the mom.
See, I don't think no. that's terrible. I feel like... I married a man who I think is like really talented and gifted and smart. He's very healthy. We need more of those kind of people in this world. I'm just saying.
So you don't mind sharing?
I wouldn't. Okay, and I also recognize fertility issues, and I would not be upset at it. I do think it is very important to protect
the identity.
The identity. I think that would be.
Would you ever wonder? See, that's my thing. Like,
no,
like what they're doing, what they become.
You see one that look like Adam, be like, ooh, is that him?
Yeah.
Is that?
I swear.
Yes.
Bro, and Israel has very signature traits. Like, his kids have beautiful eyebrows, thick, luscious hair, and like his caramel skin.
And if he could sing, you knew that.
Yeah, he comes out with drum kit, guitar, and some piano skills.
Yes.
But I just. I feel like there are people, like, if you ever had any girlfriends that really needed that or were looking for a sperm donor.
Wait.
I've had girlfriends that needed sperm donors.
Yeah.
So you would donate your husband's...
To your girlfriend?
Not to my girlfriend.
Okay.
That gets awkward because I'd be able to see the child.
Yeah, that would be weird.
I would be like Tam. I'd want to become a mother to that child. I'd want to be in their life for sure.
Okay. I froze my eggs, and let's just say if I don't use them, I for sure want to sprinkle them out and give them out to some people. I think it'd be dope to have more genies up in this street.
Yeah, I feel like
you're
healthy.
I like me. I think it would be really cool because I don't know, I think what you said, but on a personal level, I just think honestly, like, I'm so thankful for what my parents put inside of me. I'm thankful for the way I think and do I love. And if I think that there's a person out there that could actually need me or to help them complete
but
a family.
Jeannie.
I think I would be doing a great job.
A great service of giving that.
Yeah. Why did you freeze your eggs?
Why did I? Just in case, because I know I never want to say never. So I did it because I just want, in case something happens. I've always said for 5 seasons, I'm never going to have kids. But
how many do you have? Do you know if they're boys or girls?
Yeah, I have 11.
Oh, no, she has.
You have 11?
I have 11 eggs. They're so cute, you guys. Oh, my God.
Wait, you almost had a dozen.
Yeah. No, I know.
She has 11 eggs, but they're not boys or girls yet because,
oh, yeah, because
they haven't been fertilized by the sperm.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So they're just really eggs. Though. They're not embryos.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
Jeannie has 11 of them, you guys.
Okay, wait, hold on. When do you think you might give them up?
Yeah, that's a good question.
When was the cutoff?
I don't know. I look at, like, it's really weird. After you turn 40, I'm telling you guys, it's a magic age. Something.
It's beautiful.
If you really, if you really spend the time, like, get excited about your 40s. Spend all the time giving yourself love. Because when you get to that place, all of a sudden, because your heart is full and you're healthy,
right,
and you've learned how to love yourself, all of a sudden, you're open to love in so many different areas.
So maybe in 5 years,
so
we have a little.
Who knows? You might have a little,
that's
Janae.
So cool.
No,
who
knows?
Okay, so this is what I'm saying. You'll give yourself 5 years. When you hit 45, because you guys do know that these babies are currently sitting in a freezer and you pay freezer rental.
Yes.
Did you know that? So at 45, will you give them to Lonnie?
Yeah, but I got a good... Oh, shit. Oh, my God, Lonnie, that would be so good.
Oh,
we can make a little...